Here are three containers of water. The water is the same depth in each container, and the area of the bottom of each container is the same in all three cases. So the total pressure on the bottom of each container is exactly the same because pressure depends only on depth. On this container, which has parallel sides, the force, total force on the bottom is exactly equal to the weight of the water, 30 newtons. In this case, we have twice as much water, but the force on the bottom is still 30 newtons. It's easy to see that part of the weight goes against these two diagonal sides, so not all the weight hits the bottom. Now, what about this one? There's only 12 newtons of water in the container, and yet there's 30 newtons of force on the bottom. How is that possible? Let's take a closer look at that container. First, well, let's take out the water and consider two metal springs, each weighing 1 newton. If we put the springs inside the container like this, the total force on the bottom is 2 newtons, equal to the weight of the two springs, just like you'd expect. But what if we compress the springs and put them in the bottom of the T section? Now we have each spring pushing both up and down. The net force of this spring on the container is still 1 newton downward. That's 15 newtons downward minus 14 newtons upward. So the net force of the spring is still 1 newton, but you can see that the total force on the bottom is 30 newtons, much more than the weight of the two springs. Okay, so much for the springs. What about water? Now, a liquid, unlike a solid, pushes in all directions, up as well as down. So the bottom part here is just like the spring. It's pushing both upward and downward. And if you doubt that, you can poke a little hole here and you'll see the water squirting out the hole straight up. That shows that there's pressure upward. So here we have a situation where you have 15 newtons downward force here, 15 newtons downward force here, 9 newtons upward on this section, 9 newtons upward on this section. The net force of the water is downward 30 newtons and upward 18 newtons for a total net force of 12 newtons, exactly the weight of the water in the container. So that's how you can have a force on the bottom of the container exceeding the weight of the water. It's pushing up and down.